Hello everyone and welcome back. In this PowerPoint animation tutorial, you will learn how to use different pictures in a sequence to make 2D animation. This animation is a replica of Brook Wells, Embrace Your Inner Artist, at dribbble.com. The link to this animation has been given in the video description. He used Procreate and Photoshop to draw and animate different sequences of pictures. He is using 12 different pictures in a sequence and below you can see all of them. Only 6 pictures are available in larger sizes, so we must use this second picture containing all the 12 different poses of the character. So, let's replicate this animation in PowerPoint using all these 12 different poses available under a single picture. Open PowerPoint and start with a blank presentation. Change the slide layout by clicking the layout drop-down button from the Home tab and then choosing blank. You can either right-click on this picture and choose the copy image command, and then use the paste command from the Home tab in PowerPoint. Or you can also choose save image as option and then save this picture in the desired location. And then within from PowerPoint, move to the Insert tab, click Pictures drop-down menu and choose this device. Explore the location where you have saved the picture in the previous step and insert that into your presentation. Now we need to separate each of the picture's poses on a single slide, and that means we need to create 12 slides each having a different pose. Select the picture and from the Picture Format tab, click the Crop command. Adjust the crop window size to only have the picture pose within the frame. As the picture size is too small, we can increase the size from the Picture Format tab and set it to like 6 inches in height. As the lock aspect ratio is enabled by default, the width of the picture will get automatically adjusted according to the height. Make sure to place the picture in the middle and center of the slide by clicking on the Align drop-down button and then choosing Align Center and Align Middle commands. Now, for the second picture frame, we will make a duplicate of this slide by right-clicking on the thumbnail view on choosing Duplicate Slide. On the second slide, select the picture and again choose the Crop command from the Picture Format tab. Now, move the picture to have the second pose within the crop frame. We now need to repeat the same steps to have 12 slides each having a different pose. Let me show you one more time. Duplicate the slide from the thumbnail view, and then click the Crop command from the Picture Format tab. And then move and adjust the third pose within the crop window. You can also hold down the Shift key while moving the picture to move it in a straight direction. So, repeat the same steps and create 12 slides each having a different pose to the picture. Once you have all the 12 slides with different picture poses, now it's time to create duplicates of these slides in the reverse order. That is because, if we look into the animation, then we can see that all the 12 different picture poses first play in the ascending order and then in descending order. So, we will first make a duplicate of slide number 11 and will then drag and drop it below to have it as the 13th slide. We will repeat the same steps to create a duplicate for each of the slides and then place it below in reverse order. Like, we will now make a duplicate of the 10th slide and will place it below as the 14th number slide. Repeat the same steps to replicate slide number 9 and then position it as slide number 15 in the thumbnail view. We are not creating a duplicate for slides number 12 and 1, so we will have a total of 22 slides after we have done replicating each of the slides except for slides number 1 and 12. As we are going to run this animation in a loop, We don't need to have a copy of slides number 1 and 12 to make the animation smooth and to have each slide appear for the same time duration during the slideshow. Now, select all the slides from the thumbnail view by selecting the first slide and then hold down the Shift key, and then click on the last slide. Or you can also press Ctrl and a key to select all slides. From the Transitions tab, uncheck the option on mouse click, and then make a checkmark on After, and then apply a time duration according to the speed you want for the animation. Like, we are going to apply 0.10 seconds time duration for each slide. Before running the slideshow, you can move to the Slideshow tab, and then click on Setup Slideshow, and here makes a checkmark on the option, Loop Continuously until the Escape key is pressed to create a continuous loop of the animation. Now, run the slideshow, and there you have the animation ready just by placing different poses of a picture on different slides. So, I hope you will find this video interesting and informative. Let me know your feedback by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. Subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications as there are a lot more interesting tutorials to come. Thanks a lot for watching the video. Bye and take care.